Hi guys, this is Sadiq from Broadband.com, and in this video, we'll show you how to find the partitions on your Android phone and their SD addresses as well. So this will help you find the total number of partitions on your phone. And for instance, if you have a fastboot ROM or a stock firmware at hand and you could extract the firmware, then you will get the various partition file. After that, you may simply find the partition name using my guide and the video and then flash those partition file to their respective partition. Likewise, you may also use this guide to get hold of the fact whether your phone has a recovery partition or not. If your phone has a recovery partition, then you may directly flash the recovery to the recovery partition via fastboot flash recovery command. But if there is no recovery partition, then you will have to use the boot command fastboot boot recovery img, or in some cases you will have to use the vendor boot partition as well. So all these things will only come in handy and useful if you know the partition size and table on your Android phone. And in this video, I'll show you how to get hold of that information. So let's get started. As you might be aware, there are quite a lot of partition. Among them, the most important are the system one. The system is the one which holds all the important OS files. Then you have the boot partition, which has the kernel and bootloader, and it is required for the booting up of the OS. Apart from that, you have the recovery partition, where holds the stock recovery and the custom recovery as well. In some cases, if there is the recovery partition, but if there is no recovery partition, then you could flash the custom recovery in the boot partition. Apart from that, there is the data partition, which hold all your data. When you do a format data, this will wipe off all the data from your phone, or rather the data partition will be wiped off. Then you have the modem, which holds all the network files and Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, GPS, all are there inside the modem. It is also known as non-HLOS.bin or radio.img files. In the stock firmware, you may get either the modem img, radio.img or non-HLOS.bin. All these are the modem file. Then you have the cache partition. If your phone is slow and not working along the expected line, then you may delete the data of the cache partition and it should speed up the process. Apart from that, you have a few vendor partition as well. The vendor partition consists of the hardware files, drivers and firmware, which are required for hardware compatibility. Then you have the vendor boot. Nowadays, most of the custom ROMs uses the vendor boot as recovery. So the custom recovery is in fact inside the vendor boot partition and not inside the recovery or the boot partition. Those ROM are known as vendor boot or boot as recovery ROM, and these vendor boot as recovery require a different recovery. You cannot flash these recovery in the recovery or the boot partition. They could only be flashed in the vendor boot partition. Apart from that, you have a couple of other partitions, such as the PERSIS and the ODM, or ODM stands for original device manufacturer, and you have a few vendor specific files in this partition. So with that said, let's now get started with the process. So there exists two methods through which you could find the partition on your Android phone. The first one is using the ADB shell command, whereas the second one is using a third party app. The benefit of ADB shell command is it does not require root, but on the drawback, you will have to get hold of a PC every time you want to get hold of the partition name. On the other hand, if you talk about third party app, then it does not require a PC. You may directly get hold of the information from your phone. But on the flip side, it requires root, and you might be aware that once you root your phone, the safety net will be triggered and the plain integrity will fail. So you have to bypass all those tweaks as well. So we have given both the benefit and drawback. You may try out the method which is in sync with your requirement. As of now, I'll show you both these methods across two phones. One is a OnePlus phone and the second one is a Pixel phone. So I'll show you across both these methods. I'll also show you across the Xiaomi phone as well. So let's get started. First off, I'll show you via the ADB shell command. For the ADB shell command, let's use a OnePlus phone and a Poco phone. Do keep in mind, irrespective of the fact where you are using a custom ROM or a stock ROM, whether you have a custom recovery or stock recovery, the partition is not going to change. The partition will remain the same. So with that in mind, this is a OnePlus 9 Pro running a custom ROM. So first off, we have to enable USB debugging on our phone. Go to the settings menu, about phone, and tap on build number 7 times. You will get a prompt that you are now a developer. So go back, go to system, and you should now see developer option. Go there and enable the toggle next to USB debugging. You will get a prompt on your phone, tap on OK. And with this, debugging is now enabled. Now get hold of the Android SDK platform tools from my guide and extract them onto your PC. Once you have done the extraction, you could extract them anywhere you want. These are the files which you will get upon extraction. So now type in cmd in the address bar and hit enter. This will launch command prompt site platform tools. Now type in ADB devices and make sure that we are getting an ID. If you are not getting any ID, then unplug and replug your phone from the PC. Disable and re-enable USB debugging. Tap on revoke USB debugging. Use the official USB cable that came with your phone and use the USB 2.0 port on your PC. So carry out this USB tweaks and make sure that you are getting an ID. Once you are getting an ID, let's now move ahead. So now first and foremost, type in the ADB shell command and this will either give out your phone name or your phone code name. Just make sure that you are getting a dollar sign. So with this, we are now inside the ADB shell environment. As of now, it's giving my phone name. You might also get your phone code name. That's completely fine. Now type in the next command, the CD. We are now changing the directory using this command. So copy paste the command here. Just a minute. Let me copy it from here and paste it here and hit enter. And finally, use the ls command to list all the directories and paste it here and hit enter. And with this, we have got all the partition name and their address as well using the SDE. You could see the address. In technical aspect, you will have to use the addresses. So make sure to keep a tab on this address which corresponds to the partition name. Moreover, you may verify from here. As you could see, in my case, I'm using a OnePlus 9 Pro. There is no recovery partition. So I cannot directly flash the WRP recovery inside the recovery partition. I'll instead have to use the fastboot boot command. And then I could flash the recovery zip or install the recovery in the RAM disk partition, but there is no recovery partition on my phone. Then apart from that, if you want to make any changes to the boot logo, then you have the splash file as you could see, but there are two splash files, so you have to make changes to both the splash A and the splash B. So this was my OnePlus phone. Let me show you a similar method with the Poco phone. So let's keep it minimized and open a new CMD window once again, and this time this is for the Poco phone. Let me unplug this phone and keep it aside. And now we have a Poco phone. I am running a custom ROM which is based on HyperOS. So let's now enable USB debugging here as well. Go to settings menu, my device, and from here you will have to tap on OS version 7 times. You will get a prompt that you are now a developer. So go back, again go back, go to additional settings and you should now see developer option. Go there and enable the toggle next to USB debugging. And you will get a prompt on your phone. Tap check mark. I am aware of all the risk. And now you have to wait for 10 seconds on Xiaomi, Poco, and Redmi phones. After that, tap on OK. You might get an RC key prompt as well. In that case, again tap on OK. And debugging is now enabled. Let's verify the same. So type in ADB devices and make sure that you are getting an ID. So currently, I am not getting any ID. Not an issue. Let me simply unplug my phone and replug it back in. And now let me verify the result if I'm getting or not. So now I'm getting an ID. So let's now proceed ahead with the next step. First and foremost, you have to open the shell environment. So type in ADB shell. And as you could see on my Poco F5, I'm getting the phone code name, not the phone name. That's completely normal. Just make sure you are getting the dollar sign. Next up, let's change the directory via the CD command. So copy the command from here and paste it in the CMD window. Just a minute, let me copy it once again and paste it in the CMD window and hit enter. Once you have changed the directory, now list all the directory via the ls command. So hit enter and you will get all the directories. As you could see, the difference in this and the Xiaomi and the OnePlus phone is that on my Poco F5, as you could see, I have the recovery partition as well, the recovery A and B. So I may directly flash the recovery file to the recovery partition. It will not touch the boot partition, so I may obtain root via the boot partition, and at the same time I may flash the custom recovery directly in the recovery partition. Both of them will not conflict with each other. Just make sure to flash the recovery to both the recovery A and the recovery B partition. So let me show you once again. This is my OnePlus on the left, and on the right we have the Poco phone. And as you could see over here, this is the recovery file. Let me show you. On the top is the OnePlus phone and there is no recovery, but on the bottom we have the recovery file, which is the Poco F5. So this is the major difference. On the top there is no recovery, on the bottom you could see the recovery file which I have. So you may verify and compare for as many phones as you want. The command are universal, same across all the phones, across all the Android versions. So with that said, this was the first method through which you could get hold of the partition name and their address using ADB command. Let's move ahead with the next method. In the next method, I'll show you how to get this job done using a third party app. As I've told you, it does not require the PC, but you will have to root your phone via Magisk. So rooted, and once you have obtained root, let me remove my phone. Now I'll be using a Pixel phone, and this is the Pixel phone running the latest Android 15. As of now, it's obtained root via Magisk. Once you have obtained root, you will now have to install the third party app Turmux from Play Store or the third party site such as FDroid. Once you have installed the app, launch it and then tap on SU. This will give it super user request. Tap in SU and hit enter. You will get a Magisk request. Just a minute. Type in SU and hit enter. And you will get a Magisk request, super user request. Tap on grant. It has now been given the request, and now you have to simply type in this command, ls space dash la. This is the exact same command, and now then space forward slash. After that, type in dev again forward slash, and then it should be block. And after that, you will have to type in boot device. There is no space between this, so boot device. And lastly, you have to type in forward slash by dash name. So it will list out all the directories or partition on our phone by the names, and hit enter. And as you could see, we have got all the partition names on our phone. And the UI is slightly complex because the screen size is quite small, but it should give you an idea. As you could see, the partition name are here. Dave blog SDA, this is the address, and then the partition name, metadata, then GSA, FRP, EFS partition, DTBO. The partition name are on the extreme right, and just below it are the addresses. As you could see over here, let me highlight it. This is the DTBO A partition, which I highlighted, and its address is just below it, SDA18, as you could see. So you may use this command. It's the same command which we had used earlier in the ADB shell. As you could see, in the Turmux app, we only have to use the third command. You don't have to use the first and second command. Instead of the first and second command, type in SU, you will get the root access, and then simply use the third command, and you will get all the partitions on your phone. So guys, on that note, I round off this video. If you have any queries, do let me know in the comment section, and thanks a lot for watching.